Today, we're going to talk about masks and video and some of the cool things you can do with masks in Final Cut Pro. If you don't know what masks are, let me briefly explain. Let's imagine these two pieces of paper are video clips. In Final Cut Pro, when you layer your video clips, all you can see is the top clip. Adding a mask to this clip is like cutting a shape out of the top piece of paper. You still see your top clip inside the shape, but now you also see the bottom clip. Seems really simple, but there's a lot of cool things you can do with this. First, let's look at the shape mask. This mask lets you mask out any shape on a continuum from an ellipse to a rectangle. Let's use this mask to replace the screen on the iPad in our clip. Grab your replacement clip and add it as a connected clip above your timeline. If you need to, use the transform tool to resize this clip, but make sure you leave it big enough to fit the entire iPad screen. Go to your effects browser, grab the shape mask, and add it to your top clip. Up in the viewer window, you get some on-screen controls to adjust the shape. The inner ring and the green control handles adjust the height and width of your mask. Dragging in or out on the ring itself will adjust all four sides equally. Using the green handles on top or bottom will adjust the height of your shape, and the green handles on the sides adjust the width. If you drag these, both sides adjust equally. Holding down the Option key when dragging lets you adjust each side individually. The white handle in the top left corner lets you adjust the curvature of your shape. Dragging this all the way to the left side will give you a perfect rectangle, while dragging it all the way to the right will give you an oval or a perfect circle. You can change the position of your mask by dragging the center circle and the rotation by using the rotation handle that extends from the center. The outer ring lets you adjust the softness of your mask's edges. All these controls can also be adjusted in the inspector window. Let's reset our shape and adjust it to fit the iPad screen. For this, we'll need hard edges, so grab the outer ring and drag it towards the inner ring. If you don't want any feathering at all, you can also just set the feathering amount to 0 in the inspector window. Grab one of the green handles on the side and drag it out to the edge of the iPad screen. Do the same to the height of your mask. To match the corners of the iPad screen, grab the curvature handle and drag it to the edge. Zoom in on your viewer window to get it exactly on the edge. While zoomed in, go around and make sure the edges line up just right. Remember, dragging on the green handles adjusts both sides equally, so if you only need to adjust one side, make sure to hold down the Option key. With just a few simple adjustments, we have a perfect screen replacement. Another mask that works great for screen replacement, especially if the screen is at an angle, is the corner mask. Let's try this on our next clip. When you add a corner mask to your clip, in the viewer window, you get four control handles, one in each corner. Drag these in to adjust the shape of your mask. This time, instead of making everything outside our mask transparent, let's reverse it and make the inside of our mask transparent. To do this, go to the inspector window and select the Invert Mask Area checkbox. Zoom in on your viewer window and adjust the control points to perfectly match the screen. Grab your replacement clip and add it below your timeline. Select the Distort tool and drag in the corners to the edges of your screen to match perspective. In the last two examples, we use masks to combine two different clips, but we can also use a mask to highlight or add cool effects to a single clip. Let's use a graduated mask for this. With a graduated mask, you create a mask based on a gradient going from fully transparent to fully opaque. First thing you need to do is make a copy of your clip. Select your clip, hold down the Option key, and drag up to duplicate it. Place it directly above your original clip. Go to your effects browser, grab an effect, something like the black and white effect, and add it to your top clip. Go back to the masks and keying category, select the graduated mask, and also add this to your top clip. This seamlessly blends the two copies of your clip together. In the viewer window, you get two controls. You have the center control, which sets the position of your mask, and the target control, used to control the angle and the amount of gradation in your mask. Same clip, with two different looks, perfectly blended together. The image mask in Final Cut Pro lets you add a specific mask shape to your clip based on an alpha or a luma channel of another clip. Let's use this to make a video and text effect. Add a title clip to your timeline, replace the text, and make it nice and big. Drag this down below your video clip just so it's out of the way. go to your effects browser, select the image mask, and apply it to your video clip. In the inspector window, make sure the source channel is set to alpha, and click on the drop zone button to select the source for your mask. Move the cursor over your title clip, and click on it to select the source frame for your mask. Click apply clip. A mask with the shape of your text is applied to your clip for this cool video and text effect. And last, but definitely not least, the most versatile mask in Final Cut Pro, the Draw Mask. This allows you to make a complex mask of any shape by drawing it with control points. Let's use a draw mask to move this text behind our subject. Select your clip, hold down the Option key, and drag up to make a copy of it. Place it above your title clip, and turn the opacity down slightly, just until you're able to see the text. From the Effects browser, grab the draw mask, and add it to your top clip. In the viewer window, click to add a control point. A red dot with a white center appears where you clicked. When you add another control point, it's connected to your first one with a red line. Use these control points to draw a custom mask shape to outline your subject where the subject and the text overlap. Pressing Command and plus sign lets you zoom in for a closer look. Continue adding control points to make your detailed mask. Click the original control point to complete your mask. Press Shift Z to zoom back out. Now, our text is behind our subject, but when she moves, our mask is out of place. Final Cut Pro allows you to keyframe your mask, so it moves with your subject. Go back to the frame where your mask is in the right place, and in the video inspector, add keyframes to your control points and all the transform parameters. Move your playhead ahead one or two frames, and adjust your control points to follow your subject. Repeat this for the duration of your clip. Once done, click the blue pen icon in the inspector to hide the mask controls, and adjust your feather and fall-off sliders to soften any hard edges. Bring the opacity of this clip back up to 100% for this cool text behind a moving subject effect.
Wow!
Wow! As far as I'm concerned, masking and keyframing in Final Cut Pro are two essential skills everyone needs to know. If you want to learn more about keyframing, I made a dedicated keyframing video you can watch if you click right here. Thanks for watching. I'll see you back here next week.